Good morning. My name is Louise Henricks, and I live in Highland, Illinois with my son Steve and daughter-in-law Lisa, Steve and Lisa Sylvester. And I have been asked to make a church video for the anniversary. And first of all, I want to wish you all the best for this very, very important anniversary. The first thing I'm going to talk about is how the Lutheran Church has changed over the years. I remember when I was younger, all the younger children sat in the first bench, and I used to sit up there and watch the organist play. It was just very, very fascinating. The ladies sat on one side and the gentlemen sat on the other side, and the ladies had the small children with them. And there were kneeling benches, and I remember all the older ladies saying their prayers before church on the kneeling bench and before communion. All the ladies wore hats. The kids that were already confirmed sat in the balcony, and sometimes their worship was so intense it got the attention of the pastor, and he made a comment or two for them. Hymns were accompanied by the organ, no piano. Only hymns sung for the hymn book were used. I played for my first church service when I was 11 and my first wedding when I was almost 14. I was already confirmed. I started playing in the Messiah Lutheran Church in 1967, and I could have never done this, but my husband said, if you want to try this, I will take care of the kids. And they were always very, very good with them. If someone asked Stephanie where her mother was, she pointed upstairs. She was one, and her brother Steve was about 7. I remember Pastor Ashbrenner. He was the first pastor I played for. He loved classical music, so I became acquainted with classical music. He would always say, play some Bach. And so I went out to the music store and bought some music written by Bach. And I remember asking my organ instructor about this, and he said the most important thing you can do during a church service is the participation of the people. What you play before and after does not really matter, but the hymns and the service itself is very, very important, because they are participating in that. Pastor Tagmeyer, I like the way he got ready for a wedding. He gave you an outline and you had a meeting with the couple, and you just planned with them what music they wanted for each part of the wedding. All the pastors always were very, very helpful. And sometimes you got suggestions from the congregation, but that was okay. I would rather know what they wanted than do something that they did not like. The one thing I think an organist always has to watch is the order of the service and which hymn verse you're on, because you are so intent on playing that sometimes you lose your place where you are. But that's just one of the things you have to put up with. I feel very fortunate to have been your organist, and I appreciate all the help from all the other organists.
How has God used Messiah to grow your faith?
Well, I think just hearing the word often and being associated with a lot of really great people that were true believers and a lot of them became good friends. And I think as you age, you think more about your faith than you do when you're old, when you're younger. And as you age, why, your faith just becomes more precious to you.
We came to Emporia and to Messiah in the year of 1982. And I can tell you who the first persons were that greeted us at church on Sunday morning. No. It was Ella Lawson and my daughter,
Vicky.
They were greeters that day, and they were the first persons that greeted us when we walked in the doors of Messiah.
So why did you choose Messiah? Were you Lutheran Synod?
Yes, we were Missouri Synod in St. Charles also, so that's why we came to this one. So, and I'm trying to think, I don't know, do you remember, honey, if there was anybody that particularly told us about which church it was?
I don't think so, that I can recall. I moved myself down here in January of 82. And so, because it was Missouri Synod Church, and that's where I went. And so I was down here until school was out. And then Marietta came down with the kids, because we didn't want any of our kids to have to finish school down here, you know, kind of midway. And I was trucking. Different people's view and feelings about different situations. And so, I mean, that interaction was working out really well. It's a good question.
Okay, you two. How long have you been members at Messiah?
Since 1973.
Which is 49 years.
And who was the pastor?
Pastor Ed.
Did you guys originate here or did you move here?
No, we moved here from Iowa.
Moved to Lego. We had just moved here. My folks moved us down in a horse trailer into a brand new house in Lego. And they were still here because we were all sitting at the supper table. And a knock come at the door and thought, nobody knows us. Who's that? We went and here's this little short man. I'm Pastor Ashbrenner, Messiah Lutheran Church. He came in, he sat at the supper table, visited with us and visited with my folks just like he knew them from, he's just an old farm boy, so he had a lot in common with Dad to visit about farming and everything. And pretty soon he got up and he says, not ask us to come to church. He says, we will see you Sunday in church, and left.
How long have you guys been members of Messiah?
I've been a member since I was 1 year old. I was born in Leavenworth, Kansas, and my parents moved to Emporia, and I was a member, I guess, at the church on Constitution and South Avenue to start with, and then probably when I was about 5 years old, I think, then the church on 11th and Neosho was built, and it's members there. Been members there ever since I have, until I met my beautiful wife, and she was going to college at, 68?
Mm-hmm.
And we got married in 69, so.
Before that, the way they got to church on Neosho, they would walk from 606 Garfield, he and his mom and sister.
Yeah, we didn't.
Sometimes the car didn't always work.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, either that or Dad had the car, and most of the time we had to walk to church.
That's a little bit of a jump.
Yeah. We probably weren't super regular, but we did go to church.
Oh, man.
That's okay.
And then my sister in 1957 got polio, and then she was confined to a wheelchair, and that kind of, well, that was about the time for confirmation and all that. Mm-hmm. And so that kind of got delayed, and then I got confirmed, I think, by, what do you call it?
As an adult
confirmation.
Adult confirmation.
Mm-hmm. About 63.
In 63, mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's when he and Carolyn
both of us then got confirmed in 63.
Why is worship so important to you?
God's word. Can't ever get too much of that. Can't ever read too much of it.
So how has Messiah, how has God used Messiah to grow you in your faith?
Through all the Bible classes, Sunday school, logos. I think especially during Pastor Hilmer. He was one of the assistant pastors. And he, with the Old Testament classes we did and the New Testament classes we did, they were books, I know. And I remember I had to study a lot to that stuff at that time. Yeah, I was probably about 30 years old then when we did that. And I learned a lot through them. And just the Sunday school teachers meetings that we had, you know, every Thursday. That was, we had those over in that house on 12th Street that they bought for the college students.
Oh, the Lutheran and the Student Center?
Student Center, yes. That's where we would meet.
Oh my God. At least you're there.
At least you're there. God doesn't care.
As long as you're there.
God loves you anyway, no matter what.
Yeah.